Mr. Chairman, I rise in opposition to this amendment, and I would say that the pot calling the kettle black is not something that we should do. I don't know what members, if any, have had any problems with substance abuse, been busted in DUI. I don't know. But if I did, I wouldn't raise it against anyone on this committee. I don't think it's proper. And you know, I think we got to get back down to what is most important here. This is a question that stands out like a big throbbing sore toe inside of a shoe that's too small. And that is this question: is it ever okay for a president of the United States of America to invite foreign interference in an upcoming presidential election campaign?
Is the gentleman seeking an answer?
Is the gentleman yielding?
I'll be glad to answer.
The silence. The
gentleman has the time.
The silence.
What?
People respond.
Was and is deafening. And there'll be plenty of time for you to respond to that question, and I would invite you to do so. I gave you an opportunity of about 10 or 15 seconds while you could get your story together. And nobody came up with a story. So I'm going to let you move to strike the last word and explain that to the American people. It's never proper for a United States president to hold a foreign country over a barrel, to make them do that president's personal bidding, and holding needed security assistance, dangling it, and dangling the fact that I'll give it to you if you do this. I mean, that's exactly what happened. It's like the American people understand what happened. Those are the facts. The president said it when he released the transcript of the summary of that phone call on July 25th, the summary of the president's own words shows that the president tried to get President Zelensky to interfere in the upcoming presidential election. That is established by the facts. So this is not about Hunter Biden, and they've said that on the other side repeatedly up until they start talking about Hunter Biden having some substance abuse problems. You can't have it both ways. Let's be honest. This is about our conscience, the conscience of the nation, the conscience of my friends on the other side of the aisle. Do you believe that we should allow this to go unaddressed, what the president did? Because we are a country of precedent. We are a country of rule of law. We are a country of norms and traditions. Are we going to allow the violation of our norms, our traditions, our legal precedent? Because after all, bribery was not a crime. There was no criminal code when the framers passed the Constitution, but they said bribery in there. And what bribery meant was, I'm offering you something if you do something for me. I'll give you this. In other words, you give me this, I'll give you that. That's what we had in this case. That's what bribery means. It doesn't depend on a statute. It depends on what we know was done. And so let's not get bogged down in technicalities and in character assassination. Let's keep our eye on what really happened in this case and whether or not our consciences dictate that we do something about it. We can't let it go unaddressed. And the way that we deal with this grave abuse of the public trust is with the drastic action that it requires, because this is a drastic circumstance. The drastic action is impeachment, and that's why we're here today. And I ask my colleagues to let your conscience be your guide. I yield back.
Gentleman yields back.